right. So, what are we talking about? Project management tools. Okay. Here we go. All right, so let's get right into this. I will be skipping over some of the more typical features that you would expect to see with tools like this, because those are not going to be the main differentiating factors when you're deciding on which tool to go with. So I've boiled this down to 3 points of consideration. The interface, which tells us how intuitive the tool is. Is it something that's easy to start using right away, or is it going to take you a month before you even figure out where everything is? Integrations, because you're probably already using a lot of different tools already, like Google Drive, Slack, you name it. And if you choose something that doesn't integrate with everything you're already using, you're going to make your workflow more difficult. And finally, pricing structure, because some of these tools don't have pricing that's all that straightforward, and it's important to make sure you're getting the features you need at a price that's appropriate for you. And before we jump into this, feel free to hit that thumbs up right down below. And if you are new here, consider subscribing to the channel so you're notified of any future video uploads. Let's get into it. So we'll start with Hubstaff and Hubstaff Tasks. And if you haven't seen what Hubstaff can do just yet, allow me to give you a quick recap. Hubstaff provides all the essential tools needed to manage a business. Everything from activity rates and productivity monitoring to invoices and schedules. Hubstaff also integrates with over 30 other popular business software options, which does provide a lot of flexibility. But as I said, our focus here is a combination of time tracking and project management, so I will be focusing on Hubstaff Tasks, which is an agile project management tool, and it pairs seamlessly with Hubstaff. Now, simplicity is a huge part of Hubstaff Tasks, making it one of the most lightweight tools on the list. You can see the interface is clean, so it's easy to jump into and figure out exactly how to use it. Hubstaff Tasks also offers agile features, so you'll see things like sprints and Kanban boards. Here you'll see different cards for each task, and if you select a task, you'll find all the important information needed to complete it. Everything from descriptions and project due dates to checklists and comments. You can also manage time here by adding an estimate and then tracking time against that estimate right here in the task. The learning curve of a project management tool can be a big roadblock itself, and that is something we wanted to eliminate with Hubstaff Tasks. The pricing is as straightforward as the interface. We have a free plan, which is great for teams of up to 5 users, and we have the premium plan, which starts at $5 a user per month, or $4.17 a month when billed annually. Next, we have Mavenlink, and this is one of the more in-depth but complex options on this list. And I also found it to be a bit unfortunate that I couldn't sign up for a free trial without scheduling a 15-minute meeting. What I can tell you though is you can track activity and productivity with this tool, no problem. The real strength of this product is definitely the reporting capabilities, or business intelligence as it's referred to on their website. The amount of data you can sift through and visualize is pretty crazy. But it's important to think about how much time you want to devote to reporting options like this. Will you have that time to commit to it? Do you want to sift through the more granular options available, or would you prefer to have reporting emailed to you on a weekly basis automatically? That was actually a pretty big consideration for us here at Hubstaff, and that's why we like to give users the option to have reports sent to them automatically. Now let's talk about integrations. Mavenlink does integrate with a wide variety of third-party options, so that does give you some good flexibility. They also offer what they refer to as the Mbridge integrations platform, and that does support custom integrations as well. The one thing to keep in mind though is that you need to purchase the Premier or Enterprise plan for that type of flexibility with integrations. The Professional and Teams plan only integrate with Google Apps, and that's very important to think about if there are a lot of other tools you're already using, like we talked about earlier. Third, we have Replicon, and this is a great tool for project managers that oversee large teams. The interface is a bit dated, but it's definitely functional. However, this tool does offer comprehensive reporting capabilities. You can see a list of those reports here with a description of each report. And just like with Mavenlink, we do need to look at the pricing section to understand what plans actually provide you with the reporting options you'll need. At first glance, the pricing feels a little confusing. You can see things are organized by product or by segment. It gets expensive pretty fast though as you look for more comprehensive plans. You can see here the Time Bill Quick Start plan is $60 a month per user for up to 5 users, and an additional $10 a month per user after that. Fourth on our list, we have Wrike, and this offers a variety of solutions for different teams. Moving over to some general thoughts on the interface, I would say it's clean and feels modern, but also complex. I didn't feel like it was something I could jump right into and start making the most of right away. Moving over to integrations, Wrike doesn't have the most extensive list of integrations available, but it is definitely enough to accommodate most businesses' needs. You can also create custom integrations with Wrike, however, that option is only available for 3 specified plans. And 2 of those plans you will need to receive a custom quote on. For pricing, Wrike has 3 tabs on the pricing page: plans, marketing and creative teams, and service delivery teams. Out of all the options listed, only 2 show you an actual price per user monthly, and those plans limit you to a specific number of users. The business plan goes up to 200 users, so not a big deal there, but the professional plan stops at 15 users. So if you have a medium-sized team of up to around 20 people, you are going to be forced into a higher tier plan by default, and I just found that lack of flexibility to be a little unfortunate. Number 5 is ProofHub, and right off the bat, the first thing I noticed about this tool when I started a free trial was how intuitive the interface was. When you're getting started, things feel a little cluttered, but the getting started list at the top of the screen makes it pretty easy to start moving through the setup process. The side menu is pretty easy to navigate, and these different tabs actually take you to pages that, in my opinion, have a cleaner layout than the dashboard. I also noticed that there isn't a way to customize your dashboard, which is an option I prefer to have so I can prioritize the layout of information that I would like to see at a glance. In terms of integrations, ProofHub is set up to connect with 7 different third-party systems. One of the biggest differences with ProofHub is the pricing structure, so the monthly cost actually doesn't fluctuate with the number of users on your team. So as of the time of this video, the lowest cost plan is $50 a month, and that does have a fair amount of restrictions compared to the unlimited users plan, where the cost does jump up to $99 a month. Their pricing options do shift slightly if you would like to be billed annually. The last tool I'll be covering here in this video is Harvest, and this is another tool that I have personal experience with from when I was a freelancer, and I think it's a very solid option with a very straightforward interface. I do think it's a bit dated, but it's definitely easy to jump into. Next, integrations, and admittedly, Harvest has a great offering of integrations. More than likely, whatever tool you're using, you will find a way to connect it with this tool. I also liked seeing how straightforward and affordable the pricing was. You have a free plan and a pro plan. The free plan is a bit limiting, however. It can only be used by a single user and you're only allowed up to 2 projects. So there are other free plans on this list that offer more functionality. And that's going to cap off this video. We did want to try and keep it from being too long, but we do have additional tools outlined on a blog post, which you'll find a link to right down below in the video description. And if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them right down below the video and we will get back to you. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, we'll talk to you soon.